So hello guys, welcome back to channel Get to Bite. From long time, many people have asked and suggested me to start a tutorial series and videos on ARM processor based microcontrollers. So for all those viewers, Get to Bite here, presenting you the videos and tutorial series on ARM based processors, especially STM32. We will be starting with STM32 F103 development board, blue chip, using blue chip development board, and STM32 WB55, which is an IoT module integrating three IoT stacks in single microcontroller, first in the world, that is BLE, ZigBee, and Thread. I will be using Nucleo 64, its development board, for showing you the videos and for a tutorial series. So, to all the viewers who are watching first time the video of this channel, and to all the viewers who are waiting for the STM based microcontrollers tutorial series, do subscribe to the channel and do press the notification bell to get notified for the amazing videos and content to be delivered on ARM processors and the STM32 microcontrollers and its toolchains. So now, without wasting time, in this video I will be showing you with the STM32 WB55 and in the next video with the STM32 F103. So guys, starting with the hardware and the just board layout, in a brief introduction, this is the pNucleo WB55, which is the Nucleo board for our STM32 WB55, and it has all the GPIO and all the pin, these connectors, jumper wires, jumpers on the onboard with the three LEDs, as in LED indicator, LED1, LED2, LED3. Three user switches, SW1, SW2, SW3, and we have also here two these charging connectors. One is for USB connectors, one for ST-Link for our debugger, and another one is the USB user, which is the inbuilt USB peripheral. So this onboard, our Nucleo board has the onboard debugger. This section is of the ST-Link V21, which is the in-circuit debugger. This is our STM32 WBIC, and all these are the jump header pins for connecting to our peripherals of the GPIO pins and pinout and the peripherals of microcontroller. And here you can see this is the power section. These are the connectors for powering our. We need to connect the suitable connector to these pins for powering our board, and then we have to connect this one. This one is important for powering our microcontroller from the source power supply, and this one is for configuring our ST-Link debugger, connecting the pins of our ST-Link debugger to our microcontroller ST-Link pinout. And this is the rough layout, and for programming and debugging it, you just have to connect your USB cable to the ST-Link USB connector. Okay, and then you can just get start with it. You are seeing this is the antenna of our for our IoT protocols, for our Thread, for our BLE, and for our ZigBee. And also one more thing important to tell in this is that this power supply section has to be considered very well when you are powering your microcontroller. So as you can see here, there are labels like 5 volt external, 5 volt VIN, USB microcontroller, and ST-Link. So 5 volt external is the connection, we will use 5 volt external when we are using the external battery or powering the microcontroller from external source. 5 volt VIN will be used when we will power the microcontroller from these 5 volt and ground. USB microcontroller will be used when we are powering a microcontroller with this user connect, with the USB user part, okay, connector. And we will connect the USB STL when we are powering it via this ST-Link debugger part. So in our first sketch for this STM32 WB Nucleo board, what we will be doing, we will be toggling our LED1, LED2, LED3 pins, which are connected to the GPIO pins of this WB55. So now, without wasting time, let's Now, guys, if you look into the official website of STM32 in the tools and software, so there are a bunch of softwares which are recommended over here. But we will be needing only not all of them. We will be needing STM32 Cube IDE, which will be a text editor which for writing our codes, and it will also be the platform from which we can debug our code. We will also flash the firmware directly from STM32 Cube IDE also. STM32 CubeMX is for configuring our microcontroller peripherals and code. It is like STM32 provides its HAL libraries, hardware abstraction layers, libraries, full software packages, which has all the inbuilt libraries for its device drivers and for its some of its application codes. As an example, provided by the STM32 only, which are named as STM32 Cube WB. So this one is integrated with the STM32 Cube MX. Another software we'll be needing is the STM32 Cube Programmer for programming a microcontroller and for writing, erasing and checking the memory contents which of our microcontroller, of our CPU core, of our flash, EEPROM ROM directly from STM32 Cube Programmer. We will be needing STM32 Cube Monitor Radio Frequency also for our BLE applications, for checking the BLE strength and our BLE advertising and response data when we will move further in the upcoming videos. Rest of the things we will not be requiring. These are the other software tool chains other than if you use STM32 Cube IDE. Like, we can also program it from IMKIL, IER, Embedded Workbench and other bunch of softwares also, but for now we will be progressing with all the official SDKs by the STM. So I have installed the STM32 Cube MX, STM32 Cube IDE, Cube Programmer and STM32 Monitor Radio Frequency. Okay, so for writing our code, we will start first open the STM32 Cube IDE. So now, as your Cube IDE opens, go to the file new STM32 project and it will load your STM Cube Finder for and it will download all the HTTP and all the files for our microcontroller. And now, as we are using the STM32 WB Nucleo development board, so we will go to the board selector and click on STM WB and select our Nucleo board. Then click on next, your project name as LED underscore blinking. Okay, and then target language C, executable and STM32 Cube. So if you use STM32 Cube, then we will be using the HAL, all the hardware abstraction layers, inbuilt libraries and device drivers provided by STM32. If you want to create your project from own, totally from scratch, using the registers in the bare metal programming, you click on the empty. For now, we are using with STM32 Cube and then click on next. And this is the latest firmware package of the STM32, which is provided by STM32 Cube MX, that is version 1.10.0 at the time of this video. And it is showing you the other details of location of your repository and these things. So now just click on finish. It will create and it is asking to initialize all peripherals with default board. Ideally, you should not do this. You just say no, but for demonstration purpose here, I am going with the yes. So now, as your .ioc file will open, it will, from here we will configure our pins. So as you can see here that in the pinout view, your PR, PB5, PB0 and PB1 are for our LED1, LED2 and LED3. So these are by default configured as GPIO output, as we have selected the board. So in our board, it has by default selected these pins as our GPIO output pins. Now you just click on this. If you will click on this debug thing, then your project explorer will open. In the project explorer, under the LED blink, which is the name of our project, go to the course, go to the source and main.c. Then it will automatically generated all the code for initializing our GPIO pin, our system clock and our HAL initialize. HAL initialize and system clock configuration will be the default functions when you generate your code from STM32 Cube MX. Okay, so now as you will save your you will open your source and the main.c file, you just write down the code, these lines: HAL GPIO toggle pin GPIO, LED1. So this is for telling the first that the COM C, GPIO C, C port and the LED 1 on it, C port LED 2 and the C, no, not C, this B port and then another B port for LED 1 and LED 2 and for LED 3 also B port, because all of these are being connected, LED 1, LED 2, LED 3 to our PB 0, 1 and 3. So now you just go to project and build our solution. So now it will build with zero errors and zero warnings. So now for programming a microcontroller, we will use the STM32Cube programmer. I am using this one, why? Because we can directly program microcontroller from Cube ID also, but I am using programmer, why? Because it has many additional features for using, like we can write to our memory, we can read from our memory, and we can also perform the operations on option byte, MCU core, and we can also use the serial wire viewer for debugging purpose also. So this Cube programmer is quite good for exploring and for learning out the things about microcontroller in close to the hardware, to the CPIO core, to the ARM Cortex core. So now for programming it, what we will do, we will go to the erasing and programming section. Just click over it, and now you can see here there are three or four options: ST-Link, UART, USB and OTA. For now, as I have told you, we have connected our ST-Link with this ST-Link debugger with the USB cable. So we will be using the ST-Link, okay, and then connect, and then on successful connection it will show that it has time elapsed and data read successfully. Now just go to this erasing and programming section, and after, when it is successfully connected to our micro board, to our board, to our Nucleo board, you can see in the target information it has, it will show all the details of our microcontroller. Okay, and now just go to the file path and browse, and in the browse go to our to your project name, that is we have LED blinking. In that, your debug folder will be created as you, when you will debug your program, build your program. In the debug, click on LED blinking dot binary file and open, and then just write start programming. As you write this, you will see here that your LEDs, LED 1, LED 2 and LED 3 will start blinking one by one, and then these are the these, as you can see here, blue, green and yellow, blue, red and green LEDs. So, and this one is blinking because we have still connected our programmer. So just click on OK and disconnect, and as you disconnect, your programmer will be disconnected from this microcontroller and your LEDs will start blinking on this Nucleo board. So this is just the getting started video tutorial on STM32WB55. Now in upcoming videos, I will be showing some more HAL based libraries, first with UART, SPI and I2C. Then I will show and upload videos also for how to program this microcontroller totally from scratch, that is via using Nucleo board or embedded C programming and the bare metal using the datasheet. And then in the later videos, we will use the main feature of this module, that is the BLE, IoT and ZigBee part. So for now guys, that's it for now. So though, if you have liked the channel and get to know about something, then do subscribe to the channel and kindly press the notification bell to get notified for the upcoming new videos. Thank you guys.